Hello, we are going to be trying a lot of new luxury makeup today. I have the new Cle de Peau, the foundation. This is the one that comes in that really beautiful jar. I actually decluttered the one that I had before, and it looks like they repackaged, possibly reformulated this product. I purchased this, I think, from Saks, and I got the shade BF10, I believe. Where's the shade on here? Yeah, BF10, which is light buff. I'm so excited to open that up and check it out. I did, while I was at it, I did order the Cle de Peau Shine Lipstick in the shade Influential. So Cle de Peau had sent me a bunch of their Shine lipsticks because they redid their whole lip line. And the colors are gorgeous, but they're really bright, kind of like fruit punch type of shades, which are a lot of fun. But this Influential shade looked a little bit more natural, I guess. Natural, nude, my lips but better kind of a color. So we'll take a look at that. Hourglass sent me their Unlocked Mascara. Now, this is not new at all. In fact, I think this has been around for quite some time, but I don't think I've ever tried this, and I'm very curious. So we're going to be trying that. I did also purchase two of the new Hermes Fall Winter shades. They came out with three limited edition shades. I purchased two of them, so we're going to try that out as well. And then I also purchased the Dior Quint, the Miss Dior Quint that came out in this really kind of like capsule collection where they had that beautiful like flower artistry. I also purchased the Miss Dior candle. I think it was to celebrate the Miss Dior perfume, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know if they came out with like a larger size or the anniversary. Maybe it was the anniversary of Miss Dior. Anyway, I have all this trivia like mixed up in my head. Anyway, I have the Miss Dior Quint, which looked very pretty. I'm so excited to try that out. And then Cle de Peau actually sent me a bunch of their new luminizing face enhancers. I had purchased two of them and I tried them out for you already, but they went ahead and sent me four of them. I'm so excited because I love, love, love these powders. So we're gonna play around with all of this stuff. So let me get this out of the box and then we'll start with the foundation. All right, here is the box packaging for the Cle de Peau, the foundation. It has SPF 22. And it is a mixture of chemical and physical sunscreen, octinoxate and titanium dioxide. Oh, wow. Okay, so it looks like there is a tray for this to sit on. And if memory serves, there was a tray in the previous version of this as well. And then there is a spatula, which is great because this foundation is in a jar. Here's the foundation. And then let's see. Oh, and the full name of this foundation, actually you can see it on the box, is The Foundation N. Is that for new? I'm not sure. Not sure what that's for. So yeah, so BF10, I've gotten pretty pale, I want to say, since I've come back from New York. New York, I felt like I got a little bit of color. I was out walking around a lot, but I think I lost it all. So I think this shade should work out pretty well for me. So it does come with this like protective cover here, which I'm just gonna use to apply. I feel like this texture is a little bit lighter than the previous version. The previous version, I felt like it was very, very creamy. This feels a little bit thinner than that one. Oh, I'm also using a new brush to me. This is very nice. This is from Letitia Lamac. These were sent to me, and this is her N15 brush. I'll, of course, link it down below if you're interested. But this is a really nice, like, dense brush that I think is perfect for cream products. Okay, so I'm going to apply this to half of my face here so we can compare to the non-side. I'm trying to remember the coverage of the original. I think the coverage is fairly similar. I would say, you know, with the light amount I've put on, it's like a light medium. It has a that Cle de Peau floral scent in here, which the previous version also had. All right, so there it is on this side of my face. I think it's a little bit light. A little bit light for me. Yeah, I think if I were to get this again, I would probably get a shade up from here. I was getting 020 for a while there, and I don't know, that just started to look really warm on my skin. So yeah, I got BF10 in the last foundation. I got that radiant cream foundation, the one in the tube, and that worked out well for me. But this one seems a little bit lighter than that. Maybe it's the sunscreen in there that's kind of like
doing a little something. But I did see on the Cle de Peau site that if you are into more of like a radiant finish foundation, then this is definitely one for you. I don't see anything like I look like utterly glowing or anything like that. I feel like I just have a really nice sort of healthy kind of sheen to my skin. And I will say, I definitely feel like this one is less radiant than the previous version of this. The previous version of this, I felt like I was putting on like a very moisturizing cream onto my face that was simply tinted. This is not quite as creamy as that one. All right, I'm gonna finish applying to the rest of my face here. There it is, all over my face. I think you guys can agree, this is too light. I look ghostly, at least in the viewfinder I do, and I can see that even my neck looks a little bit deeper than my skin up here. It's okay, we can always bronze it up if we need to. All right, so that is BF10. So if you use me as a shade reference, I think BF10 is a little bit too light, a little bit too light. But in terms of like texture and finish, I really, really like it. I think I may prefer this to the old one. Like I said, the old one was really, really creamy. And while I have really dry skin and I didn't mind it so much, I thought it looked really nice. To put that on top of like all of your other skincare, which is, you know, what I do. I never kind of substitute my makeup for my skincare. It was a lot. It was just kind of a lot on the skin. And it was like one of those foundations I really only felt comfortable wearing like in the dead of winter when my skin was really, really dry and it was just kind of soaking everything up. I felt okay putting that on top of like everything else. This version is definitely much less like creamy and moisturizing. Not to say it's drying or anything, but it's just not as like thick as the last version, at least not in my opinion. Please let us know what you think. If you've tried both, let us know down below in the comment section. I'd like to hear your feedback. But anyway, it is very, very nice and it feels really nice on the skin. It almost feels cooling, like it's almost like a gel kind of version of it. That's what I mean by lighter than the previous version. Yeah, it definitely has like a lightness to it. Okay, so that is, so, oh, let me just show you what it looks like in its little stand. Here we are. So you can just leave it on your vanity like so. So fancy. Okay. Well, I wish I had a new bronzer to try. That would be like perfect timing. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put on some of my Sisley powder on half of my face because I am very curious about how this is going to wear. And I will leave a pinned comment down below and also in my description box letting you know how everything wore. But I'm just going to put this onto the right side of my face, the powder, that is. And this is the Sisley Press Powder in number 2 Natural. All right, I do need to throw on some bronzer. I do feel like I look very, very pale. I've got my Hourglass Elephant Palette here. So I'm going to use the bronzer in the corner there. And I'm going to use my Sonia G Jumbo Bronzer. Just start to warm up my face a little. Okay, I feel a little bit more alive. Let's go ahead and open up all of these Cle de Peau Luminizing Face Enhancers. I'm wondering if there's one in here that is one that maybe I could use as a blush. So this one is number 17, Celestial Sparks. This one, I believe, is for the lightest of skin tones. Let me do a swatch of this. Now, all of these have oversprays, I believe. So my swatches are going to look a little bit more sparkly. Actually, this one looks pretty smooth. I don't think this one had that much overspray. Anyway, here is Celestial Sparks, number 17. This is like white, a white, white highlighter. God, look how glossy that looks. So smooth. Okay, that is number 17. Here is number 203, Sunset Brilliance. Ooh, this could be one that could work as a blush. Let's do a swatch of this. This one definitely has an overspray. Oh, wow. It's like a light coral. That's really beautiful. Okay, so that is Sunset Brilliance. And here is 201 Twilight's Glow. Wow. Let's see what this looks like.
Ooh, so this is very cool toned. I don't know if you can see that. It has like a cool tone, like pinkiness to it. Ooh.
All right. So they also sent me Shooting Stars, which is one that I had. So I'm not going to open it. I'm going to set that one aside. But let me go ahead and swatch the two that I have alongside these three. So this one is 202 Golden Galaxy. Here is Golden Galaxy. And this is the one that I really like to use as a highlight on my skin tone. Again, for shade reference. So that's Golden Galaxy. And then here is Shooting Stars. So there's Shooting Stars. So that's the bronziest of the bunch. Wow. Okay. I think actually I could probably use, I'm going to use Shooting Stars as a blush. It's kind of a bronzy shade, but I think it's bright enough that I can use it as a blush. It won't look too close to the Hourglass that I just applied, but we'll see. I'm trying another Letitia Lamac brush. This is the FF7. Well, it's definitely very glowy. And I think it works as a blush. It is actually very close to this Hourglass. It is just a little bit shinier. So let me apply some, just so we're doing things evenly. Let me apply some to this side. And then I think I'm going to layer on the peachier one. I can't remember the name right now. Yes, Sunset's Brilliance. So this is the peachier one, this one in the middle of the back of my hand. I'm gonna layer this on top and see if it makes this stand out a little bit more. Could be too light. Well, you definitely don't need highlight if you're gonna use these as blush. A lot of glow going on over here. And just so you know, so I put powder on this side of my face, no powder on this side, and I feel like my powder application for both the Hourglass and these luminizing face enhancers are the same. I don't feel like this foundation is particularly tacky or that you need to set it down with powder, just FYI. But again, I have very dry skin. All right, well, those are beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Okay, I'm gonna just throw in some brow gel into my brows and we'll come back and play with the Miss Dior Quint. Oh no, one of my shades is broken. I think it's okay though, let's see. I'm just gonna, press that back in there. See what happens. I thought I opened this up and checked. I guess I didn't. Okay. Oops. Making a bit of a mess here. All right. I'm just going to hold this up gingerly. But there's the Quint. It definitely has like a pinkiness. It's like a in the family of pink is what I'm trying to say. Let me do some swatches of all of these shades. Oh, the really pretty kind of shimmery shade is the one that's broken. I'm bummed. All right, so those are the five shades. So here's the one that cracked, that's shimmery. It really is a topper. It's actually very, very sheer. This one's a satin and this one's a matte. So these two are matte. The lightest and the deepest are mattes. All right, I've got another Letitia Lamac brush. This is brush number N5. It's like a flat shader. I am gonna go into this shade here. It's like the mid-tone pink in here. And brush this all over the lid. Ooh, this has such a pretty finish to it. I hope you guys can see that because in the pan, it looks like it would be almost like a matte, but it has this really gorgeous shimmer to it. Then I'm gonna take this center shade. I'm just gonna use the same brush and just add it to the outer corners here. It's a very interesting combo. Okay. And then I'm just gonna use my finger and go into this shade that's cracked, unfortunately, the topper shade, and just tap that on. I don't think the shade is doing much, actually. It's so thin. I don't know, maybe under some strong lighting, you may be able to see it. Yeah, it's adding like a little bit of sparkle. It's brightening up the area a little bit, but not that impactful. Not as pretty as it looks in the pan. I'm going to take this Sonia G detail brush and go into the deepest shade and line my eyes. This is a nice, like, purpley brown. There isn't a lot of red to it, which is good because I think you may run into the problem of looking, you know, sick, that like pink eye situation. But I think the cooler tone of this brown kind of saves it. All right, so there's the Miss Dior Quint. I would say the only shade that I'm really, really taken by is this one down here. This is just like a matte brow bone that I didn't even use. And then the rest of these, like this one was really not impactful, the one that's cracked. And then these two deeper shades, they're okay. They're all right. Nothing like earth shattering, but that pink is really, really pretty. All right, I'm gonna curl my eyelashes and then we can, or you can watch me try on the Hourglass Unlocked Mascara because I'm sure everyone else out there has tried it. I actually can't remember if I've tried it. I don't think so. If anything, maybe like a little tester or sample of it. So this is the Instant Extensions Unlocked Mascara. This isn't looking that familiar. Did they have a mascara that was like in a triangle shaped tube? That one I think I've tried. Anyway, let's go ahead and check this out. Ah, so this has like a plastic bristle wand. Yeah, I definitely have not tried this one. It does a nice job lengthening. And I thought when I first put it on that the formula felt a little bit thin, but now that I'm kind of working it in, it is definitely kind of thickening up a bit. So that's good. I don't personally like very thin feeling mascaras. They just become quite messy. Okay. There is the unlocked mascara. That's nice. That's nice. It did a little bit of volumizing, a little bit of lengthening, like a little bit of everything. And my lashes are still curled. Interesting. All right, so that's the unlocked mascara. And then finally, we've got a few lip products to try. So we've got those two Hermes lipsticks. Let's actually start with these. So these are all in the matte finish. So I was really on the fence whether or not I wanted to try them. I'm just not always a matte lip wearer. But then I remembered the Hermes matte lipsticks are actually very, very creamy. And I mean, they're far from glossy, but they're not like a really dry kind of matte. So I thought, why don't I try it? Because the colors looked really, really beautiful. So this first one is number 62. I'm not even gonna try and slaughter that, but it's Matte Rouge FEU. And here is that shade. It's such a beautiful, it's like a fluorescent red. Isn't that gorgeous? So let me try this. I don't think this will necessarily go with the rest of my look, but stunning shade. Wow, that is a terrible application. Sorry, I like got a little crazy over here. But anyway, you get a sense of this color. Wow, this is not for the faint of heart. This is a really bright color. Yeah, it's like a fluorescent red because there's a little bit of orange in there, but it really is mostly red. Wow. This is a great holiday color. Holy smokes. All right, let me take this off and we'll try the next one. Okay, this one is 76 Matte Rouge. I'm gonna say cinnabar, but it's probably pronounced differently in French. This is a beautiful rusty shade. Look at that. Gorgeous. Okay. All right, there is number 76. This one is a touch warmer. It's just as bold as the other one, but not quite as bright and glowy. But this one is fantastic. I'm so glad I got these. I was really on the fence, and I'm so glad I remembered that the matte formula was really, really comfortable. Really doesn't feel matte, and I don't feel like they look drying on the lips. That's good. Okay, that kind of stained my lips a little bit, but I think I got most of it off. All right, let's try this Cle de Peau Shine Lipstick in Influential, and it's number 211. That's the shade number. So here's that new packaging from Cle de Peau. So pretty. And, oh, it's a little bit pinkier than I thought. Actually, this will be perfect with my eye look. Oh, pretty. Oh, fun. So that is influential. That's such a pretty, pretty pink. Yeah, and it goes beautifully with this eyeshadow. Awesome. I just love it when a trying new makeup works out, because sometimes they don't. Sometimes they just don't work out. Anyway, those are all of the new luxury products that I wanted to try out for you. I'm going to leave a pinned comment and a section in my description box letting you know how everything wore. But taking a close look at this foundation, it looks amazing on the skin. I mean, I do have some other things on top. Of course, we have the hourglass. We have some of the powder on this side of my face. But it looks great. It looks great all around my problem areas too. Like my nose, between my brows. Yeah, everything is looking really good. I think the only thing I would do, and I'm going to do that now, is I'm going to add a little bit of blush just because I feel like we've got eyes and lips, and then I feel like this kind of gets washed out because I use such like nude shades. And since I have this elephant palette out, I'm going to apply just a little bit because I also don't want to be like just like pink blotches everywhere. So I'm just going to apply a little bit of this center pink shade, which is, I forget the names are on the back, iridescent coral. Yeah, just dust a little bit onto my cheeks here. Yeah, just to kind of bring it all together. There we go. I feel like that looks better. All right, now we're all done. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments section. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe down below if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video.